हेलो स्टूडेंट, टुडे आई एम गोइंग टू डिस्कस यू अबाउट द टाइप्स ऑफ प्रॉब्लम दैट वी डील विथ इन द डिज़ाइन एल्गोरिथम्स। फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल वी शुड अंडरस्टैंड द प्रॉब्लम व्हाट एक्चुअली इट इज एंड वेदर इट कैन बी सॉल्व और नॉट सॉल्व, वेदर देयर कुड बी एन एल्गोरिथम फॉर दैट प्रॉब्लम और नॉट। दिस मे बी लिटिल बिट confusing to you, as you will learn that there are certain set of problem which cannot be solved using some algorithm within given time, or that cannot be solved at all. And depending upon the problems, we categorize the problem into five following category that I am going to discuss. Types of problems. Of problems. First category that first, second, the problem that can be defined formally but cannot be solved theoretically. Right, and third, the problem that can be defined as and can be solved theoretically, can be solved theoretically. And fourth one, problem that can be solved theoretically but practically not feasible to solve. First, I shall discuss you about these four category, then I shall discuss you the other categories of the problem. First, here the first category is the problem that can be formally defined. We cannot define every problem in a formal way. For example, if there is a problem and if you will not cannot define that formally, then how will you design the algorithm? There are certain problems because you can consider certain problems, like suppose there is a problem that you understand that this is disturbing you, but if you cannot identify that what actually the problem is, there is something that is disturbing you because of, suppose your car is not working and there are some malfunction in this, but if you do not know that what is the actual part because of which it is not working, then you cannot solve that problem. In real world you can define most of the problem, but there are problems that depends upon many factors, and in that case you cannot clearly defined. Like in today's scenario, the coronavirus is the virus which has not, there are not clear symptoms on basis of which you can certain define with surety that this is the coronavirus only. it has the similar symptoms like the normal flu that are generated with the normal cold viruses, due to cold viruses. So it is very difficult to identify. Now there are some certain tests through which we can, antigen test and other tests through which we can define that this is the case of the virus. But initially it was not easy to define that what are the certain symptoms on basis of which we can say that this case is of coronavirus. So now we are able to define that problem, but still there are many more problems which cannot be even defined formally. So the other category, we shall discuss it later also, but there is a pattern between these. The next category is the problem that can be defined formally but cannot be solved theoretically. There are problems that can be defined. Suppose you want to calculate the expanse of the universe. You can define that universe is so vast and it is it contains million or billions of the galaxies or solar systems, but you cannot actually, it is not theoretically feasible to calculate the expansion of the universe. So this type of problem where we can define that what would be the expansion of the universe, but we cannot theoretically measure or verify the expansion of the universe, comes into the category where problem can be defined but cannot be solved theoretically. Next category is problem that can be defined and can be solved theoretically. There are problems that can be defined and that can be solved theoretically, and the another one is problem that can be solved theoretically but practically not feasible. As I have told you, because suppose we want to calculate the create a detailed ecosystem of and analyze the detailed ecosystem of the oceans, then this problem can be solved theoretically, but practically it is very difficult to go to every nook and corner of the oceans and analyze the ecosystem of there. So this problem can be solved theoretically, but this comes into the category where it cannot be solved practically, or it is practically not feasible to go to each and every corner of the sea and check out that which kinds of animals are present there and what kind of different bacterias or other thing are available, because ocean is so wide and we have limited resource. So practically it is not possible to claim that we have analyzed or searched the whole of the ocean and we know the every kind of living creature inside the ocean. So after this, why we are discussing this series of problems? Because now today I am going to discuss you about the pre-problem. Now we shall more formally define a set of problem that can be defined, that can be solved practically, and they take polynomial time to solve that. So the another category that I am going to discuss after these problem is the problem that can be solved theoretically and that can be solved practically also. Okay, problem that can be solved theoretically and practically practically. So the last category is problem that can be solved theoretically as well as practically. So in this category there are certain set of problems. So on the basis of that, we categorize the problems into with different name. So the problem I'm going to deal with are the P problems. The P problems are the problem, I'm going to grab this page. The P problem. Okay. the P problem or the problem comes into the category, the problem that can be defined, that can be solved and solved within polynomial time. Means problem is well defined, problem is well defined. Dusra, can be solved using deterministic Turing machine. Deterministic Turing machine right, and third takes polynomial time to solve. So the P problems are the problem that can be defined, that can be solved using the deterministic Turing machine. As we know that we can generate an algorithm for only that problem which can be solved using the Turing machine. But here I have used the word deterministic Turing machine, and these problems takes polynomial time. Polynomial times means if suppose input is of size n. Then time is equals to n raised to the power k. Means where k is a number which is a polynomial of k. It means if input is of size n, then the algorithm will take at most n raised to the power k number of times to give the result or give the solutions. So these problems, which are all the problems for which we can generate the deterministic Turing machine. So these are the problem which we can, most of the problem we deal in with our life are the polynomial problems, like the algorithm that we have studied, shortest path routing techniques, Bellman Ford, Dijkstra, Kruskal, Prim's, or the sorting technique like selection sort, merge sort, insertion sorts, all are comes into the this category, because their problems can be solved using deterministic Turing machine. They will take polynomial time. Polynomial means polynomial of n, where n is the input data, size of the input data. And if the problem cannot be solved, and these problems can be verified also. For the verification, we can verify that the solution that we have claimed that is the solution of this problem can be verified, or this problem is also essential, because somebody is claiming within n raised to the power k time that this is the solution. It doesn't mean that it would be correct. You will verify that whether this answer is correct or not. So there is a verification algorithm for the polynomial problem which generate a certificate that this solution is right or wrong. So first of all, I shall give you some example of the P problems. So I'm going to write some examples of P problems. P problems example. Satisfying the Boolean expression. Suppose I am writing an expression x dash y plus y dash x is equals to 1. This is an equation for which I want to find out whether this problem can be solved within a given polynomial of input size or not. Here two inputs are is equals to x comma y. So for each combination of x comma y 0 0 0 1 1 0 and 1 1 there are four possible inputs because we are dealing with the boolean, and in boolean there are two values for a variable 0 and 1. So for all these combination we shall check out for which value these equations are satisfied. So in that case, this case, suppose I am checking for 0 0, then 0 1 into 0 plus y dash 1 into 0 is equals to 0. And in second case, this is 1 into 1 plus 0 into 0 is equal to 0. Similarly, in this case, x dash y 0 into 0 plus 1 into 1 is equals to 1 is equal to 1 is equals to 1. And in this case, 0 into 1 plus 0 into 1 is equal to 0. So only two solutions. So x solution. So these two combination, first, second, are the solutions with limited number of steps. There are total four number of options. There are four options, and this is the multiple of 2 raised to the power 2 number of inputs, where this is the input, suppose input n raised to the power 2, because for every input we are considering the two options. So it is the depends upon number of inputs power. So these are the total number of options that could be possible for given set. So we can verify this, and finally we can have verified this result. So now this algorithm has a polynomial of take polynomial times to get the result, and it can be verified also. So this problem will come under the category of the P problem. When a problem give you solution, you can solve a problem within polynomial time, and you can verify that result also, then that problems is called said to be the polynomial problem, or in short the P problem or P problem. So the satisfying of the Boolean expression is a polynomial problem, and likewise many of the problem, most of the problem that we have designed the algo were the polynomial problems. So the other category, the problems that cannot be solved in polynomial times, comes under the category of the NP problem. In NP problems there are certain categories like NP complete, NP hard, and co-NP, but we shall discuss it later. Today we are discussing the P problems. So this is an example of P problems. So for the what is the verification of algorithm, I am going to discuss you about that, the verification algorithm. Because here in this example, for the there will be the verification algorithm. In verification algorithm, for the given solution, suppose this is the verification algorithm, then Vx, suppose the input is, for the given input xy would algorithm would generate, where A is the algorithm, on certain input it would generate a result 1 if the result is true or verified. In case of verification, the verification algorithm generate output 1, and in case the result is not verified, then it generate 0. It should not verification algorithm should be such designed, should have a certificate that its certificate generate 1 only when the result is verified, and we can claim that this result is this result is 1 only if the result is satisfied as per the given algo. If it is not satisfied by the given algo, then the result would be 0. So for the given algorithm, for the given input, if the certificate generate 1, then that algorithm is verified, otherwise the algorithm is not verified. So in short, we can say that the the P problems are the problem which can be defined theoretically, which can be solved using the deterministic Turing machine, and which takes the polynomial time, where polynomial of their input n means they will take n raised to the power k times. The most of the problem for which we have designed the algos were the polynomial problem. But many of the problem that we have studied as polynomial problems, when the number of the points increases or in certain situation, these problems may become NP problems. So there is no clear cut boundary between P problem and NP problem. This may sound confusing, but for example, the traveling salesman problem, finding the shortest path algorithm traveling, and the graph coloring problem, which you have solved and you have designed the algorithm for that also, you consider them that they are the polynomial problem. But when the number of cities increases in case of traveling salesman problem, the same problems becomes an NP problem. Means the same algorithm which you have designed for the traveling salesman algorithm or the graph coloring algorithm does not work, or because of that you get the wrong result, or the algorithm start taking infinite time, and it is quite possible that some of the solution are not discovered through the given algorithm which may exist. So with increasing number of nodes or increasing complexity of the problem, certain problem which were considered as a polynomial problem goes into the category of the NP problem. So it become very difficult, or the partition between the P problem and NP problem becomes so blurred. So in simple word, we can say that problem, that's P problem, comes under the category of P problem, goes into the NP problem category, NP problem set. So how to this is a great problem, that how to define that this certain problem is P problem or NP problem. And one important thing, there are various problem which are considered as NP problem. And if you are able to solve one NP problem, then you can solve that other all NP problem also. So today I stop my lecture at this P problem. In next lecture, I shall discuss you about the NP problem and how they are related with each other. Thank you.